students of class 10, welcome to the second part of your revisional video of the chapter Waste Management. In this chapter, we will start from the concept of waste management. What is the meaning of the waste management? In last video, we had done what is waste, what are the types of waste, different types of waste, their definitions along with examples, and why do we need waste management. Now here we will read what is the meaning of waste management. Waste management, what is the definition of waste management? Waste management refers to the necessary, it is the necessary step to take in the reducing the normal level of waste generation. All these activities are many formed together known as waste management. So what is waste management? Waste management is the procedure or the plans or the way through which we can reduce the generation of waste at the initial stage. So this is the definition of waste management. There are three different ways by which waste can be reduced. Waste can be reduced. These are called three R's. You know this? Three R's. What are the three R's? Reduction, reuse, reduction, reuse and recycle. These are the three R's: reduction, reuse and recycle. So what is reduction? We have to read the definition of all the three. What is reduction? Reduction is the procedure of generation of the waste at its source. That is, it is also called, known as source reduction. At the initial stage, at the generation, at the point of generation, if we take necessary step to reduce the generation of waste, that is called waste reduction. What are the examples? Suppose if instead of recyclable, means instead of thermocol in a normal tiffin box, some people are using what? The thermocol cans or thermocols that, aluminium foil to take the tiffin. So it will generate waste. We cannot do that. We should use tiffin box. Instead of normal battery, if we can use the battery that can be chargeable battery, that is called the chargeable battery, and that chargeable battery is also very important. So at the initial stage, that is the process of reduction of waste at the initial stage. So this is the reduction. What is reduce? Reduce means the generation of waste, means that you can use the things again and again. How? We can donate our old book to the library, old usable book in the library in your locality, so that other people can use. Our old computer we can donate to the other people in the locality library, in the locality club you can donate your usable, old usable computer, so that it can be used by others. So this is the reuse, means again and again the things can be used, otherwise that thing will become waste. So instead of making the thing waste, we can convert into a usable thing. Then recycling. Recycling is the process of used material into new useful product. Recycle is the process of used material into new useful product. That is, we can use, you can recycle paper, we can recycle iron. So this is the process of recycling of waste. Clear? So these are the three R's: reduction, reuse and recycle. Now there are different processes of waste disposals. What are the processes of waste disposals? The processes of waste disposals are the different process. There are different, three different waste: the solid waste, the liquid waste and the aqueous waste. And the three waste can be properly recycled. So here we will read about in detail. The first is the segregation of waste. Solid waste, can be segregated. What is the meaning of segregation of waste? Segregation of the waste means separation of waste. What is the meaning of segregation? Segregation means divisions or separations of waste at the initial stage. That is, what we will separate? Solid waste means biodegradable, non-biodegradable waste we can separate. They are all a solid waste. Under solid waste, they are biodegradable, non-biodegradable. We can separate the biodegradable and non-biodegradable waste. And this is the first thing. Secondly, the landfilling. Landfilling is a process of dumping the waste in particular area so that the area, that a low-lying area, can be increased in height. And composting is a natural biodegradable waste process by which the organic compound can be turned into nutrient for the soil, plant. That makes the soil fertile. It provides manure, it provides fertilizer. For example, if you, the used means the eggshell, fruit cells or the peels of vegetables or the tea leaves can be thrown in one area and that will add organic fertilizers and manure to the soil. The liquid waste can be, liquid waste is normally disposed by proper drainage system. So before disposing the liquid waste in river or ocean, it must be treated. That is, sewerage treatment is the most important process. And gaseous waste can be separated by the process of scrubbing. So, scrubbing is a process by which the gaseous waste can be separated. Okay? And scrubber, what is scrubber? Scrubber is a airstream pollution control device which uses liquid spray to remove solid and liquid particles materials. Very, very important. What is scrubber? Scrubber is an airstream pollution control device which uses liquid spray to remove solid and liquid particled matter. Okay, now what is the role of students in waste management? Very, very important. What is the role of student for 5 marks? Here you have to write in point wise. 5 marks, 5 points. You have to write. So what are the points? How the student can create generate awareness? Generate awareness among the people about the need to clean environment through placard, poster and road shows. Encouraging people for segregation of waste at source. Means separation of waste at the source. Suppose at house we can, from the house we can separate the biodegradable and non-biodegradable waste in through separate buckets. Thirdly, they should regularly monitor waste management system in their locality and prepare report on them. And fourthly, on special day like Earth Day, 2nd April, on the World Environment Day, 5th June, students can conduct separate programs. They can collecting, transporting and disposal of waste. They can organize program to aware the people. So these are the role of waste. Very, very important from this part. And last part, the effect of waste on Bhagirathi Hooghly River. This part is not so important, but they can come here. You can get the Namami Ganga project. This part you can get here. Here you will read once, go through the part once, so that you can write, means not so important, Ganga action plan already given once, and Namami Ganga, these two projects must be done. So this is the end of the chapter, and I think there is no problem, very easy chapter, revisional video done. I think you don't have any problem. In the next video, I will discuss the question answer from this chapter that already given. Again, I will discuss the question answer from in the next video. Thank you, class.